Hello, I'm R.L. Stine. I write the Goosebumps books.
Few authors have left a mark on the world of children's literature quite like R.L. Stine has. With a career spanning decades, Stine has achieved major success, becoming a household name among generations of young readers. His remarkable accomplishments in the realm of storytelling have not only captivated the imaginations of millions, but have also woven a rich tapestry of nostalgia that connects people across different ages. In this video, we'll delve deep into the man behind the spine-tingling tales and discover the enduring impact of his stories and the cherished memories they evoke in the hearts of readers, both new and old. Robert Lawrence Stine, better known by his pen name R.L. Stine, is a prolific American author, primarily celebrated for his contributions to the horror and young adult fiction genres. Born on October 8, 1943 in Columbus, Ohio, Stine's childhood was marked by a love for reading and writing, which laid the foundation for his future career. Stine's journey into the world of literature began at an early age when he started writing short stories and jokes as a kid.
I was 9 years old, and I found this typewriter and dragged it into my, it was in the attic, and dragged it into my room and started typing little joke magazines and little funny books and funny stuff and typing stories.
He said as a child, he always wanted to be a comic book writer, but that his drawings were never that great, so it led him to just focusing on writing, with his inspirations coming from authors like Ray Bradbury and Edgar Allan Poe. After graduating from Ohio State University with a degree in English, he moved to New York City to pursue his passion for writing. He went to work for Scholastic, where he started his career as a writer by creating humor books for children under the name Jovial Bob Stine.
I wrote joke books for a long time. I just wrote joke books.
His experience as the editor-in-chief of Bananas, a humor magazine, further honed his skills in entertaining young readers.
I had a great time. I did this humor magazine called Bananas for 10 years. It was sort of Mad Magazine, but it was all in color, and it was great.
Stine coasted on this success until the late 1980s, and it was around this time that he transitioned to the genre for which he would become famous for, horror. In 1986, Stine released Blind Date, his first horror novel. After one successful horror hit, he never looked back. He went on to create the Fear Street series in 1989, which introduced readers to the eerie happenings in the fictional town of Shadyside. Fear Street quickly gained popularity among young adult readers and became one of the best-selling young adult series, with Stine writing more than 100 books for the series. And it became a great stepping stone for Stine's next future project, one he wasn't so sure about. The pinnacle of Stine's career arrived in the 1990s when he created the Goosebumps series, which is perhaps his most iconic work. But he didn't even want to do it originally.
I was writing Fear Street, one a month, killing off teenagers. And it was a YA series and doing really well and was doing great. And they said, we have to try a horror series for 7 to 12-year-olds. No one has ever done it before. And I said, no way. And they kept after me and said, no, we have to try it. And then finally I said, all right, if I can think of a good name for the series, we can try two or three.
Compared to his Fear Street series, these books targeted a slightly younger audience and were characterized by their clever blend of suspense and humor. He originally signed on for 4 books, and at first they didn't do so well. But by the time the 4th book had a release, word started to spread around the playground and the series took off. With titles like Say Cheese and Die and Night of the Living Dummy, Goosebumps became an instant classic, captivating children around the world. The Goosebumps original series produced over 60 books and was adapted into a successful TV series that aired from 1995 to 1998. Growing up, I loved the Goosebumps TV show and would never miss an episode. I remember watching The Haunted Mask when it first aired and being instantly hooked. I always loved when they would do the 2-part episodes like One Day at Horrorland. R.L. Stine's impact on the literary world extends beyond Goosebumps. He has authored numerous other series, including Fear Street, Mostly Ghostly, The Nightmare Room, and The Haunting Hour, that also went on to be a hit TV series for 4 seasons. If you haven't seen The Haunting Hour series and you like Goosebumps, I would recommend you check it out. My favorite episode is called Grandpires, and it stars Christopher Lloyd as well. a grandpa that's a vampire.
Is that a rat? Is that blood? You're a vampire?
R.L. Stine's books have collectively sold hundreds of millions of copies worldwide, making him one of the best-selling children's authors of all time. Stine's contributions to literature have earned him various awards and accolades, including a Guinness World Record. His influence on pop culture and children's literature is undeniable, and his work continues to engage young readers and inspire future generations of authors. To this day, R.L. Stine has written over 200 books for the Goosebumps series alone, with books still being released to this day. The brand has gone on to make two films and has released a new TV series in 2023.
A most chilling experience is waiting for you. You can make your next party a real scream with a Goosebumps ice cream cake for a limited time from your local TCBY treat shop.
R.L. Stine's career is a testament to the enduring power of storytelling. With his ability to craft tales that both terrify and amuse, he has left an indelible mark on the world of children's literature. His books continue to be cherished by readers of all ages, and his legacy as the master of fright remains firmly intact. Not too bad for someone who's been called a training bra for Stephen King. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, I'll see you on the internet.
What's so scary about that? You'll see. Viewers beware, you're in for a scare.